Hi everyone, welcome again. Today we'll learn about UiPath Reframework. In this session, I will explain you complete walkthrough of Reframework in UiPath, why it is required to be used in our regular UiPath development or UiPath testing script. I will also give you detail of configuration file, what all stages are there and how it is implemented. So if you are new to this channel, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for more updates. Let's begin with complete walkthrough of Reframework in UiPath. So whenever we are working with several processes, it's always required to have an established process which we can use for business cases. So just like here, whenever we are talking about business process, there are three types of business processes are available. One, linear process, second is iterative process, and third is transactional process. So let's understand what does it mean and how we can use or how we are using in regular life, in terms of programming or in terms of other things as well. So after that, we'll discuss about the architecture of UiPath Reframework. So linear process is, whenever we are talking about the linear process, there is one input and related with that, there is some output. So if you can see this example, there is an action, it means this should have some input and pull that will get a result, that is output. Means one way of inserting data and we are getting respective response based on the input and the logic which we have built in our program. So that is called as linear. But when we are working with complex process, it's not very much suitable to use that linear process again and again. So just like if I want to send mail or one time mail, definitely it will be okay to send one time. But if I want to repeat the same process again and again, then definitely that will require an iterative process. So in iterative process, we are giving certain conditions. First we are initializing, then there should be a condition and post that the execution of that. But what happens when we are using the iterative process again and again and we want to kill it or we want to drop in between while running? So it might be happen that our code will destroy all the response which is already generated, or our code will corrupt. Just like take an example of operating system. If we don't go by process to shut down every time, definitely our OS will corrupt within 2 or 3 shutdown. If we directly press on power off button or remove the charger, so something like that, or the power. So the possibility of corrupting its code is very important. So we cannot kill the process in between while it's running. And just take an example of any process which will take or last for the execution to be end 24 hours, but I want to kill the process after running in first hour, then definitely my code will corrupt. For avoiding these type of cases, transactional process will help. So this is the example of iterative process. We are giving condition. Unless and when condition is satisfied, we will get a response. But if you want to kill the process in between that, then there should be some challenges. So transactional process always help. So first it will take input, condition and the output. Second run, it will take input, condition and output. So at any point of time, if third process is completed, I want to kill it, Definitely, I will do that. So RV framework will work just like that. So if you can see in the architecture, architecture itself have initialization process, get transaction data, process transaction and process. I will show you in detail whenever we are talking about the RV framework, and we have created one project here. So for creating a project or opening the project in RE framework, just have to go to Robotic Enterprise Framework and we have to open this. So after opening that, you are able to see this page where initialization, end process, get transaction data and process transaction, these traits are available. So let's first understand what is RE framework, then we will discuss about their architecture. So Robotic Enterprise Framework is a template within UAPA Studio built using street machine layout. So these all are states. So initialization, end process, get transaction data and process data or process transaction is the streets. So you can see here, these streets are listed here. At a high level, it provides an excellent exception handling mechanism, retrying a field transaction, application recovery, and the ability to stop the process where continuing to run the bot does more harm than good. Reframework enables us to put the external setting in configuration file, that is config.xlx. I will definitely cover that part as well in further part of this session. File an orchestrator asset instead of hard coding settings like a shared network path location or credential within the script. So reframework is a process independent. Any type of process can be built, tested and run irrespective of it being attended or unattended. And regardless of the process, data type and the applications we are automating, that reframework provides simplicity and ease when automating with event logging or exceptions and logging around other relevant transactional information. It also sends those logs to the orchestrator for safekeeping. The logs can also be configured and sent to Elasticsearch, Logstash and Kibana platform for a more visual way of representing the data. So whenever we are talking about the each and every stage, it's always start with the initialization. If it is successful, it jumps to the get transaction, and if get transaction data is successful, it will move to the process transaction. What happens if it fails? Then process transaction return back to the get transaction and repeat the process until it ends. The same way, when there is no data available, it directly jumps to the end process. This is a step which we can cover it. So let's understand each and every step in detail by opening each and every code. So whenever we are talking about the reframework, this is a well covered or structured template which is created for the UAPA developer, which they can use it at any point of time in between their code modification or creating the script. So this will provide better exception handling technology. So let's understand. So these are the states. It means we have four states, that is initialization, second is processing or get transaction data, then third is process transaction, and fourth end process. It means we have four states, and let's see the transition. So if you can see here, this is the first transition, first and second. So if it is successful, it jumps to the get transaction data, otherwise it will throw an exception and end the process. It means two transition is here, then if get transaction data is successful, it jumps to the process transaction. This is the third one, and when there is no data in get transaction data, it will jump to the end. It means 4 and 1, 2 and the third is here. So it means 3 years. It means 7 transitions are available in RE framework. So we'll discuss each and everything in detail. First, this is the folder structure which is created after opening the RE framework project. So here you can see all the structure or structure format folders are already created. Each and everything is saved. So this is the screenshots folder, settings, then data. So if you want to keep your data, you can save it to here. In between the data, you can also find configuration file. So configuration file, when you will open that, you are able to see different or three sheets are available. In first sheet, you are able to see settings where you can orchestrate the queue name, process ABC queue, that's the value and description. So these are already defined. If you want to include some more or add some more column or row, definitely you can add it. So log or business process name is also available. So these are the default value created by system, but you can also update it or add it according to your requirement. Second is constraints. Whenever we are talking about the reframework constraints, you are able to see max retry number, which will give you the maximum retry for any script. So if you want to send a request to the server which will retry for only 3 times, then you have to change your value to 3 here. X screenshots folder path. So you can also include your folder path or exception screenshots folder path, log messages, get transaction data, then the log message get transaction data error, log message success. Apart from these default value, you can also include it additionally. So this is assets sheets is used for the future purpose. You can use it if you want, but if you don't want to use it, you can keep it for your future perspective. So let's understand how it works. If you have hands-on experience working on UiPath Studio, we might aware that UiPath Studio has 3 types of data flow: representation, sequence, flowchart, and street machine. So reframework contains all of these data flows, but the main structure of the program is built using a street machine, as it provides a cleaner and more desirable data flow representation. UiPath has the following components in order which they can call me in the template. So template is basically it's created which we can use it, which will provide us the reusability feature. Since the system can only be in one state at a time, at least one transition condition from a given state must be true for it to move to the another state. If it fails in any of these states, reframework is built in and either retry it or end the process, send an exception log with the reasons. So let's see initialization process and which all part we can declare it or it's already defined. So in this state, we are initializing all the settings and the application required before the bot starts working on the business end of the process. For example, if the process we trying to build is to upload an attachment in SAP, we first require the bot to fetch the credential from orchestrator, open the SAP application and log into SAP using the credential. UiPath reframework is built in a way so that one can initialize all the applications necessary here in the init state, and if the condition we have built are met, the bot will then move forward with processing the transactions. If there is an error while initializing the application or the credential provided are invalid, an exception notification can be sent from within init state and end the process. So let's see how it is created. If you can see here, it is well structured, and each and everything is defined in a proper manner. So if you can see here, the assignment state where system exception initialization is done. If there is a no exception, it will write nothing and return to the main process. So anyhow, when we are working with any flow or script, initially there is a no exception. Because of that, it's mentioning here nothing. After that, if first runs read local configuration file, so config is nothing here in initialization state, but you can see here in first run you will find several other activities that are also used. So it will invoke init all setting workflow where init all setting dot jaml is created. So let's see in the folder where we can see that. So in input there is the input, output is the output. So these are already created, but you can change it according to your requirement, or you can also add the additional folder as per your project needs. So these are the documentation which is provided by the RV framework team, and it is well explained. If you want to go through differently, you can refer this. This will definitely help you to work with RE framework in UiPath. So exception screenshot will be stored here, and let me show you. These all processes are already created, that is close all application, get transaction data, init all application, init all settings, which you can use it as per your requirement. There is no need to change anything. If you want to kill any process, you can directly call this XAML file or this sequence. So because of that, here it's init all setting will be called. So let me show you where it is. So this XAML is directly called, and you don't need to write the code again. So because of that, I said reframework is built for the reusability of the code. It's already built by the team. You can use it as per your need. So there is the import argument, three arguments are there. Variables are also defined. You just have to manipulate it according to your requirement. Transaction item, system exception. So these all variables are already created and define the default value, but you can update it as per your project needs. Now here you can see orchestrator queue name is specified, where orchestrator configuration name or queue name is provided, and the assignment is also there. So at the end it will kill the process and return to first run. It means the init process is completed here. So let me go back to the actual init process. So it will start with assignment state or check with the exceptions. After that it will run, and once the run is complete, it will call init all application workflow, where it will execute the code. And here you can find it out the catches or exception handling method which is already provided. Because of that, I said exception is well covered in reframework. Transition is also provided here. If you got successfully, definitely it will jump to the get transaction data. Otherwise, if it is failed, end the process. It means it is designed in such a manner developer will not confuse. So just like in an organization, multiple developers are working on small components. If one person is creating for single functionality A and second one is creating for functionality B, they are not having coordination between them unless and until team lead will assign the tasks together. So if they will build their own component together, it's and they will work with this type of framework, then team lead will integrate their part, because he know that one person is working on A functionality and second one is working on the functionality B. So that is about the initialization step. Let's see get transaction data. So in get transaction data, you can see here retrieve data is available. It will check stop signal and after that stop or get. So there are several other processes are also available like orchestrator, stop request, to get transaction data. And even though if you want to see any property here, you can change it according to your requirement. Let me open it again. Here it called get transaction data.xaml and based on that it will run the code according to your requirement. Again here there is a exception handling is handled and transition is also provided. So if it is successful, it jumps to the process transaction, and when it will found no data, it will jump to the end process. Let's move to the third component, that is process transaction. In process transaction, business rules are defined, and if there is no exception found in between the business rule, it will show nothing. After that, it will jump to the process, and again here there is an exception handling is working, and transition is also used here, so you can get the actual path where it is jumping. So it will not having that much pain while when you found any error and you want to track it where is that error. So when there is a system exception, it will jump to the initialization. System exception means when there is some error in system or network issue or any environment related issue, it will jump to the initialization step. When it comes to the business exception, just like if I defined I want to send an email to the 1000 people and the email ID which I provided is not valid one, definitely it will occur an business exception because data is not correct which I have provided here. So definitely it is a business exception and jump to the get transaction data. When there is a successful, it will jump to the get transaction data. Last but not least, that is end process. End process is having feature to close the activity or end the process when our execution is completed so that our system will run successfully. And if I want to open the next time, definitely it will run with the process. So let's understand the get transaction data. Once the bot has successfully initialized all the application it requires for a process, it will then look if there is any transaction item in the orchestrated queue to process. The bot will then process the item in the queue one by one by monitoring the queue. If there is no more items to process, the bot is then going to end the process and close all the applications. We can also have the process look at the spreadsheet, database, email or web API instead of orchestrator queue depending upon the business requirement. If you want to stop request is initiated while the bot is in between processing the transaction item. Brief Rework has a pre-built functionality to look for a stop request and will stop the process even though there is an item still in the queue to process. This will be helpful if you notice the bot is not doing what it is expected to do that. Third is process transaction state. In this state, all the process specific workflow are invoked. Going back to our previous example, SAP documents, the bot has now initialized. The SAP application got the transaction data from the queue and the bot should now upload the attachment to SAP. So here is the process state, all the activities to attach the document we have invoked. For example, a workflow to check if the document exists on the shared path, a workflow with activities like clicking on relevant GUI element for the bot to navigate through SAP, type in the file path and look for an acknowledgement the document was successfully attached. Once the bot has finished processing a transaction item, it can either be a successful or failed transaction. We would now want to see the status of each of the transaction item. This can be achieved by a pre-built set transaction status workflow in Re framework. With this, we can set in transaction status of an item to either success, business exception or application exception, which I explained earlier. So business exceptions are pre-built exceptions that are built into the script and which the bot should be looking for. If the bot processes the transaction successfully, the transaction status can be set to the success and the bot will now move forward with the next item in the queue. End process. After the bot has finished processing all the transaction items from the queue, it will log out of the application, close them in the state. This is the final state of reframework and the application are closed irrespective of it is failed or successful transactions. So let's understand the advantages of using this. So first advantage is logging. So exceptional logging mechanism to monitor the process and error handling is well covered in Re framework. Scalability, ability to retry failed transactions multiple times and send exceptions notification is very much possible in UiPath Re framework. Third is consistency. So variables, assets and orchestrator settings are consistent across Re framework and will be easy to understand, and the code standards will be allow for a more painless handover to a different developer. Reusability works for any type of processes and business logic code is separated from other aspects of Re framework like exception handling, which enables it to be used across multiple processes. Error screenshots. Re framework has the functionality to take the screenshots of the screen at the point where it failed, which is useful in unattended automations and overall troubleshooting. Error handling, which we have already discussed, it is well equipped with the exception handling and error handling, which is system error or business error. So that's all about Re framework. Let's recap. We have started with the basics of Re framework. Then we have seen about business processes, which all business processes are available. Then we have discussed about architecture of Re framework. After that, in each state, we have discussed in detail how the process or workflow is moving from one step to the other. And by using several examples, I explain here how we can use it in real life scenario. Then the configuration file we have checked and discussed each and every point in detail, like max retry and the logging mechanism. Post that, we have discussed about the advantages of using Re framework. This is all about UiPath Re framework. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you really enjoyed the content, press thumbs up and don't forget to like and subscribe the channel for the latest update. Thank you for watching.